Captain's log, stardate Armageddon.
The Klingons were too far distant to have been the attackers.
What proof do we need? We know what a Klingon is.
Helm dead.
The clones have gone crazy. Something's taken over.
Most interesting. The bulk of your crew trapped. Your ship racing from this galaxy at wild speeds. How did I perform this sabotage, Kirk? All my men are here.
Do you think some people in a cave? Do you think some people in a cave were able to have NORAD stand down? Do you think that people in a cave were able to have all of this happen?
A phantom colony, imaginary distress calls, the creation of these weapons.
We will in fact find weapons.
Do you sense a pattern, Mr. Spock?
The potential for the disastrous rise of misplaced power exists and will persist.
There is an alien on board which may have created this situation.
Who cares what started it, Mr. Spock?
It is apparently capable of manipulating matter and mind.
I think we should just trust our president in every decision that he makes.
This is war!
There isn't any war!
You serious? I've got men in sick bay. Some of them dying. Atrocities committed on their persons. And you talk about making peace with these fiends.
The alien is the real threat. That's the enemy we have to wipe out. Has a war been staged for us? Complete with weapons and ideology and patriotic drum beating.
He used gas? But where did he get the gas? From us.
Recent events would seem to be directed toward a magnification of the basic hostilities.
And here is that agenda, the project for the new American century.
Much of what these men wanted is coming true. They urged that the U.S. abandon the anti-ballistic missile treaty. It has. They wanted establishment of more permanent U.S. military bases abroad. That is happening in the Philippines and in Georgia and will likely happen in Iraq. They urged regime change as a goal of foreign wars, not just in Iraq. They wanted the U.S. as a global constabulary, their word. Such aspirations are unlikely to be realized without a catastrophic and catalyzing event, like a new Pearl Harbor.
Apparently, it is by design that we fight. We seem to be pawns.
But what's the game?
It's known as the Bilderberg Group. Could their objective be world domination?
We must push outward if we are to survive.
And the Constitution has not given permission for us to so-called police the world.
We have always fought.
Either you are with us, or you are with the terrorists.
As you've been listening to propaganda.
Shut up!
There's another way to survive. Mutual trust and help.
We ought to stay at home, mind our own business, trade with people, and be friends with people, and we all would be a lot better off.
There's an alien entity aboard the ship. It's forcing us to fight. We don't want to. We don't know what its motive is. We're trying to find out. You must help us.
It is most urgent that we locate the alien entity immediately.
The Federal Reserve is an independent agency, and that means basically that there is no other agency of government which can overrule actions that we take.
Now, do you believe? What did you want? What are you doing here?
Kill the Klingons! It's them or us, isn't it?
Tell them!
When the lieutenant became unconscious, the alien lost energy.
It subsists on the emotions of others.
This one appears to be strengthened by mental radiations of hostility, violent intentions.
It exists on the hate of others.
To put it simply. And it has acted as a catalyst, creating this situation.
in order to satisfy that need. It has brought together opposing forces in an effort to promote the most violent mode of conflict.
We've got to get rid of it.
Then all hostile attitudes on board must be eliminated. The fighting must end, and soon.
Oh, we're a doomed ship. We've got to pool our knowledge.
We must find a way to defeat the alien force of hate, stop the war now, or spend eternity in futile, bloody violence.
It has to stop.
Look, gang, for the rest of our lives, 1,000 lifetimes, senseless violence, fighting. While an alien has total control over us. And it goes on and on, the good old game of war, pawn against pawn. Stopping the bad guys. While somewhere, some thing sits back and laughs. And starts it all over again.
He is telling the truth.
Be a pawn. Be a toy. Be a good soldier that never questions orders. This is Captain Kirk. A truce is ordered. The fighting is over. Lay down your weapons.
This is Kang. Cease hostilities.
The cessation of violence appears to have weakened it, Captain. I suggest that good spirits might make an effective weapon.
Get off my ship. You're a dead duck here. You're powerless. We know about you.
Everyone wants an inside job!
And we don't want to play. Maybe there are others like you around. Maybe you've caused a lot of suffering, a lot of history, but that's all over. We'll be on guard now. We'll be ready for you, so ship out!
Only a fool fights in a burning house.
Out!